This is ground control to Major Tom. You've really made the grade, and the papers want to know whose shirt you wear. Now it's time to leave the capsule if you dare. This is Major Tom to ground control.
Now, I know the word gardening might bring back images of your mom yelling at you to go weed her front walk or water the garden, but I want to reintroduce the whole concept to you. In fact, we're not even going to call this gardening. We're going to call it grounding. And I think you'll find that along the way, you're going to feel more grounded. So the ideas and gardens we see each week aren't going to be like your mother's garden. But this isn't your mother's gardening show. This is ground control. It's springtime, and just like your apartment needs a good cleaning, so does your yard. So grab yourself a good rake and a pair of gloves and get ready to feel the burn. That's right, you didn't think we're going to be working out during this segment, but we're going to be working on your yard and your body. Raking really is a full body workout. Not only are you working on your arms, you're going to work your chest, abs, and legs. So your yard's going to look better, but you're going to feel better. I know you think raking means bagging, but think again. We're not bagging anything. We're going to build a compost pile that I'll show you later on. And don't forget to actually stop and smell these once in a while. That is why we're here. It's great to unwind in the country, but after a long day of working in the yard, I'm ready to get back into NYC. Here we are, back in the concrete jungle, or concrete garden, I should say. Check it out. Look at this brownstone. It has some great window boxes out front, and it's really early in the season. Let's check it out. A lot of these buildings have great gardens hiding behind them that you can't see from the street. Sort of like a little surprise. Yes, this is New York City. Okay, so since we're doing container gardening today, the first thing that we need is a container. We have here a plastic window box, which is something to think about when you're living in an urban environment. It's easy to carry home because it's lightweight, and it's not going to be as fragile as terracotta, and they look exactly the same. I found this one at the Chelsea Garden Center, which is actually where I bought all the plants that we're going to use today, and you can find anything you need. Okay, you're going to fill the box about 3/4 of the way full. You're just trying to get an idea right now to see how much soil you need and where you're going to place your plants. Today I'm working with petunias and alyssum, which are both great window box flowers. So just take them out of the plastic and break them all up, figure out where you're going to put them. One side note about the soil. Always buy fresh soil. Even if your pots are already full from last year, there's a lot of nutrients inside the packaged soil that will really help your plants through the season. And you always seem to need more than you think you're going to, so if you think you need 2 bags, buy a third. It can't hurt. Don't be afraid to dig in. This is beautiful, rich soil. Look at that. It's like chocolate cake. Okay, so we know we have enough soil, and you've spaced out your plants. So now, we actually plant them. This is the fun part. You can't make a mistake, so just go ahead and pop them in. Here's where you can get creative. Arrange the flowers any way you'd like. Some people like to do solid blocks of color, and others really split it up. I usually do try to split them up. To me, for some reason, if it looks too uniform, it's too sweet. I don't like it to be that precious. One tip when window boxing, make sure that you use enough plants. Nothing looks worse than a half-filled box and a really wimpy statement. You want to make it look full and lush. Make sure you pack the soil down in to get rid of all the air bubbles. In no time at all, you have a great window box. Look at that. Get it in the sun and water it well. Hall of Fame window box flower, the pansy. Comes in loads of colors, super hardy, and flowers all season. And guys, you won't feel like one buying them. You don't actually have to say the name, just pick them up and take them to the register. A great way to get inspired to do some gardening is looking through magazines. And I'm not talking about gardening magazines, I don't even have any. Whatever magazine you read, just check it out and you can see colors and patterns and it'll give you a lot of ideas. You might find a really cool pick that you think looks really interesting. And then you might even see a really corny picture that actually has a flower in it. Whatever. Sometimes the simplest idea can make the strongest statement. And every time you look at it, it will make you happy, because you know you did it yourself. And some plants like this come back year after year. How great is that? So every week, who knows where you'll find me? I might be up a creek without a paddle, cutting my finger on a thorn bush in the woods, and of course, in the city. Because it doesn't matter where you live, you can always have ground control. Okay, enough. I'm out of here. You get the gist. Thanks for watching.
This is Ground Control to Major Tom. You've really